So second feature is record block. Okay, I'm gonna run this section. There is a new block called record block, which has been introduced. So that block is available in libraries, syncs. We have this record block. Okay, so this record block, we can view the results and also we can log data to different places. Let's look at the help of this block documentation. So it says log data to workspace, to a file or both. And also you can use the record block to visualize connected signals. Let's run and see how it works. Running it. And I double click on the record block. I can see the data. So sine wave, pulse signal, and also square wave. So I am able to visualize the data. So here there's a show signal. You can, when you click on it, you can see the signals. So you can select them like this and you can see the results. Okay, now also there are some options, like you can select the layouts. Okay, and also you have an option for select visualization. So in the visualization, you are right now, spark lines are selected. You can also select time plots, maps, XY, and text editors. And there's an option called record. When you see this, you have this to workspace and to files. Okay, so when you run the simulation, the data will be recorded to workspace. Let's see if it is recorded to workspace. And also to the files, you have three options, three file formats. Okay, right now it was, when I was simulating, it was in MLDATX. So you can see a file called recording MLDATX. And let's see the output. When I double click on the output, you can see record data, record out. And you have three values. So first one is sine wave. Second one is pulse signal. And third one is square wave. Let's see the values. Values are here. So when you double click on it, you can see time and data. Time and data. Okay. And when you go back to the model, you see this. If you're saving this in the form of Excel sheet, okay, go to this and run it. And you can see an Excel sheet. See, Excel sheet is here. So you can open this. Double click on it. You can see time, sine wave, pulse signal, square wave. And when you log data using a record block, it directly logs into data inspector. You can see a data inspector is highlighted. When you click on this, you can see the data inspector highlighted here. So in this case, we can select one layout. We can actually edit view. We can take one time plot. Okay, we can take time plot and we can select a signal. We can select sine wave here or pulse signal together or square wave. And also we can change the edits. Like we can have spark lines here, three, and you can select the signals, all three signals, and you can bring them here. There's also a new option available in Data Inspector. That is this one here. You can animate the results. Like when you click on this, you can see. I'm not actually running the simulation, but I'm just directly animating the results. Okay, so you see here, this one, this file is actually a data inspector file. When I click on it, double click on it, I get a data inspector. So you can share this file with your colleagues and they can directly run the results like this. They don't have to actually run the simulation. They can run this and they can view the results. Okay, we have seen this record block. In the record block, there's an option of map. Okay, for this, I have to choose an example. Let me open that. To view the graph and the record block, I have chosen UAV data, a path of the UAV, longitude and latitude values. And this latitude and longitude values, we are going to view in the map. Okay, so I run this section and I can see latitude, longitude values in the workspace. These latitude, longitude values are fed into the record block. Okay, so I'll open the, I've chosen 2956 points. You can see here, 2956 points are chosen and I've taken step size as 1. Okay. So that's why I've taken time as 2956. So I'm running it. And let me open this record block. I can see the map here. Let me make it a bit. Yes. So now I see the signal. I'm selecting latitude and longitude, both of them, and I'm getting them into this. And I'm hitting OK. And I'm going to run it. Now I see the path. This is a path the UAV is going to take. And it's going to start from here and end here. Okay, now I want to see how in which direction, you know, in what path it is going, UAV. So what I do is I go to data inspector. Here I change view to map. Okay. Then after that, I select latitude and longitude and I get them into this. Okay, now I can see the same thing. Now we have this option to animate it. So what I'm going to do is there are a lot of points, 2956. So I'm going to increase the speed so we can view it properly. I click it and you can see the marker moving now. Okay, so you can see, so UAV is going to trace this path. You can also zoom it. You can pan it. Okay. So you can, if you have any other model which you want to look into the map, you can use this option. And this map can be of two types. It can be street view or satellite view. When I click satellite view, I can see the map like this. Okay, when I click street view, I can see the map.